ओके, नाउ वी कम टू द इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट. ये आप लोगों को एटलीस्ट पता होना चाहिए. ओके, इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, स्पेशली द ओरल सर्जरी गाइज एंड पेरियो गाइज. आप लोग भी काफ़ी एक्सटेंसिव सर्जरीज करते हो, फ्लैप सर्जरीज करते हो, तो दिस कैन कम इन हैंडी. बट आई विल रन थ्रू इट प्रिटी फास्ट. सो एनाटॉमी भी देखेंगे. सो दिस इज द मैंडिबुलर नर्व. आई एम जस्ट शोइंग यू द रेलेवेंट ब्रांचेस, सारे नहीं दिखा रहा हूँ. सो दिस इज द मैंडिबुलर नर्व कमिंग आउट. वी हैव द इंफीरियर एल्बो नर्व, वी हैव द लिंगुअल नर्व, वी हैव द बकल नर्व दैट इज क्रॉसिंग द एंटीरियर बॉर्डर ऑफ द रेमस. देर आर अदर नर्व्स ऑल्सो, नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट. सो बेसिकली क्या होगा, वेन वी आस्क द पेशेंट टू ओपन द माउथ वाइड, ओके, द कॉन्डाइल इज इन क्लोज अप्रॉक्सिमेशन टू द एंटीरियर ट्रंक ऑफ द मैंडिबुलर नर्व. ओके, सो नाउ इफ वी आस्क द पेशेंट टू कीप द माउथ ओपन वाइड एंड इफ फॉर and by any technique somehow we deposit the LA in this region, we'll be able to block all of the branches that come after this point. Okay, so that is the Goget's technique, basically short mein. Okay, band kar deta hu. Anyways, so it is a true mandibular nerve block because it usually blocks all of the sensory innervation, sensory branches of the mandibular nerve. Mandible mein there are other motor branches also, we're not talking about those. It is a true mandibular nerve block because it blocks all of the sensory branches. Okay, and it has a very high success rate. अगर आपको properly technique आ गई एक बार, so you won't do any other block. आपको इतना पसंद आएगा ये. Okay, and the difficulty is that it requires a lot of experience to master this technique. Okay, now anesthetize में क्या होगा, we have the lingual nerve, buccal nerve, myelohyoid. इस point के बाद जितनी branches आती हैं सारी nerve will be anesthetized. So inferior alveolar, lingual, buccal, usually majority of the cases में buccal, because sometimes this buccal nerve is branches out at a higher level also. So in majority of the cases, around 75% cases, buccal nerve is also anesthetized, lingual, inferior alveolar, myelohyoid, and aur kya bacha, mental, incisive, ye sare. Okay, once you know the branches, ye sari cheeze yaad karne ki zarurat nahi padti hai. Okay, so this was your site of injection, nerve anesthetized bol diya. So area that is anesthetized with this one injection technique, जिसमे हम सिर्फ 1.5 ml LA दे रहे हैं, which is similar to that of inferior alveolar nerve block. उसमें we are giving all of the lingual tissue that is blocked, buccal tissue, all of the mandible is blocked, buccal mucoperiosteum is also blocked. Okay, in majority of the cases, 75% cases, buccal is also blocked. Okay, and lip. So half of the mandible is totally blocked with just one technique. Okay, so it can come in handy if you find it difficult to give inferior alveolar nerve block or lingual or buccal, or if you want to perform an extensive surgery, by jaw surgery kar, by jaw as in dono side ka, third and fourth quadrant dono kar rahe ho aap. Okay, and if you want to avoid toxicity, okay, mere case mein ho chuka hai, maine patient mein toxicity bhi kiya hua hai, so you can go for Goget's because the total amount of LA that you are administering to the patient is less. Okay, now contraindication, again if there is infection at the site of the injection, okay, then there is lip anesthesia. Okay, so in case of children or mentally challenged patient, we are going to avoid this block. Or if you give the block, make sure that the patient is under your observation or any adult supervision. Okay, so as I mentioned, it has a high success rate, it requires only one injection, and sare nerve sensory branches are blocked, and aspiration rate is low. It is very successful. Okay, yeah, I forgot to mention this point. Inferior alveolar nerve block mein there was bifid mandibular canal, bifid nerve. In that we had to give another block to block the second one, the one that was at a low position. Whereas in this case, we are depositing the LA before the nerve divides into two, right? So even if there is bifid inferior alveolar nerve, we have a successful block with only one injection technique. Okay, the problem with this is as the trunk is thick. Okay, now remember this, when the LA acts, the LA molecules, they have to travel into the nerve, okay, through the nerve fibers, and it has to reach the core fibers. Sare fibers block honge, then only the patient will have the pulp anesthesia also. Okay, now in this case the nerve will be very thick because we are targeting the nerve at a very higher level. Okay, so the nerve is very thick and it will take a longer duration for the to achieve pulpal anesthesia. Okay, but if you follow my technique, block deke patient ko bahar bitha do and prepare for the surgery, ho jayega. Okay, and it requires a lot of practice experience to learn this technique, but once you learn it, you won't do anything else. Okay, so as I mentioned earlier, we are going to deposit the LA. The target site is the anterior portion of the condylar neck. Okay, this. And a landmark, we have this area. Iske tragus ke just niche, this is called as intertrachic notch and the corner of the mouth. These are the extraoral landmarks. I'll show you how to use these landmarks. Intraoral, we have the mesiopalatal cusp of the second molar. It is going to ascertain the height at which we are going to insert the needle. Ye bhi bataunga main. Wait. So, this is not important. Orientation of bevel, because we are approaching the condylar neck at almost 90 degree. It is not 90 degree, but almost 90 degree. So, we can disregard the direction of the bevel. Okay. So, what you are going to do is, extraoral landmarks, the corner of the lip and the intertrachic notch. You're going to draw again an imaginary line. Asli mein line draw nahi karna hai. But you can try shuru mein if the patient allows. Okay. So basically, aapko karna kya hai? This is how you use the extraoral landmarks. Corner of the mouth and intertrachic notch pe we draw an imaginary line. Intraorally, we use the mesiopalatal cusp of the second molar. Is level pe, we are going to insert the needle. Remember this, we are not going to insert the needle buckle to the second molar. We are just keeping it here just to see ki kis height pe hoga. Then we move it posteriorly. Okay, distal to the last molar. We move it distal to the last molar. At the same height, we insert the needle. Okay, at the medial to the ramus. Okay, so basically, aapko isme karna kya, you are going to target aapka needle, keeping it parallel to this, you are going to target the ear. कान की तरफ अगर नीडल आपने डायरेक्ट करी बीच में कॉन्डाइल आ जाएगा एंड देन यू डिपॉजिट दी एलए. शॉर्ट में बताऊं तो ये है टेक्निक. सो यू ड्रॉ द इमेजिनरी लाइन, यू असर्टेन द हाइट यूजिंग द मेसियोपैलेटल कस्प ऑफ द सेकेंड मोलार एंड देन वंस यू असर्टेन द हाइट यू मूव इट डिस्टली, यू इंसर्ट द नीडल एट दैट हाइट एट द मीडियल सर्फेस ऑफ द रेमस डिस्टल टू द लास्ट मोलार. इंसर्ट करो, कीप इट पैरेलल टू दिस लाइन एंड यू विल श्योरली हिट द कॉन्डाइलर नेक and deposit the LA. Okay, so this is where we block all of the mandible. We achieve the total mandibular nerve block. So subjective mein kya kya aayega, we have the lip anesthesia. So lip numbness will be there, tongue numbness will be there. Okay, isko bol do piche jaake so jaye. You go back, sona hai to seriously aap piche jaake so jao. Okay, and objective, of course, there won't be any pain while instrumentation. Okay, when you poke the soft tissue with the instrument, there won't be any pain. Okay, again, the precaution, do not deposit LA if the bone is not contacted. The same thing as inferior alveolar nerve block, Holzer technique. Failure to achieve anesthesia, isme, if you deposit the LA too less, as I mentioned earlier, we need, the nerve trunk is thick, so you're going to deposit at least 1.5 ml of the LA solution to achieve profound anesthesia. आप उससे कम करोगे, there won't be enough LA to travel inside the nerve trunk. You won't be able to achieve proper pulpal anesthesia. Okay? Then there is a possibility that there is nerve anatomic variation. As I mentioned earlier, the anatomy is never absolute. There will be some variation. Angulation of the ramus will be higher. Along with the angulation of the ramus, condyle भी तो साथ में जाएगा ना? And then angulation of the condyle, anatomy will be slightly different in every patient. So there is anatomic variation. So this is what I always say to my PGs, master the technique, uske baad agar fail ho raha hai, blame it on the patient's anatomy. Ek bar aapki technique sahi ho gayi na, aur agar fir bhi LA block nahi ho raha hai, patient ki anatomy sahi nahi hai. Okay, so complication mein hematoma, it is usually by the internal maxillary artery, but it is very rare. Trismus is also very rare. If you don't contact the bone and you go into posterior and deposit the LA, you might block the third, fourth and sixth cranial nerves, and that will lead to the symptoms of diplopia, blepharoptosis. Okay, tongue twister. So usme kya hota hai, just eyebrow hai na upper, it droops down. So